Hello guys, this is Revan from DG Integrity. Welcome to Tech News episode 127. Battlegrounds Mobile India is now officially available in the country for all gamers to play, hence completing the official return of PUBG Mobile in India's cyberspace. Now in celebration of the game's return to India, Korean publisher Krafton has announced a two-day introductory event that will held between July 8th and 9th and features some of the biggest and well-known players of the game with their clans, called as BGMI Launch Party. The two-day gaming event will mark the revamped game's first official tournament in the country, supported by Krafton itself. IQ Z3 5G is enjoying a special discount at the ongoing Amazon Smartphone Upgrade Days sale, wherein interested buyers can get the smartphone at a price starting at ₹18,490. This included a limited period discount of ₹1,500, which makes the phone cheaper than before. This offer makes the IQ Z3 5G already one of the most affordable phone in terms of specifications on offer, and even more interesting purchase to consider, and thus make it a certifiably good smartphone to consider when buying a smartphone in India under ₹20,000. The Samsung Galaxy F22 have been launched in India. The specifications include a 6.4-inch display, MediaTek Helio G80 processor and a 48-megapixel quad camera. Samsung Galaxy F22 price in India is set for ₹12,499. The Delhi High Court Tuesday directed Twitter to inform it by July 8th as to when it will appoint a resident grievance officer in compliance with the new IT rules after the microblogging platform submitted that it was in the process of doing so. Justice Rekha Palli took exception to the fact the court was not informed to the earlier appointment of the resident grievance officer was only the interim basis and he has already resigned. The High Court pointed out that only an interim RGO was appointed by Twitter and a wrong impression was given to the court on May 31st, as it was not informed that the officer was on interim basis. Paytm Postpaid Mini aims to offer small loans to customers. The digital payment company is giving access to loans ranging from ₹250 to ₹1,000. It is said to help users pay monthly bills such as mobile and DTH recharges and gas cylinder booking. Multiple reports have claimed that Realme is gearing up for the launch of new Master Edition phone. It seems that its arrival is not far easy as Realme CEO has teased its arrival through a tweet. It seems to be teasing the launch of the Realme GT Master Edition. An ecosystem accessible to all without sacrificing quality, Realme's goal for the global market is no longer just a project. In fact, after presenting some products in recent days, the Realme TechLife Air Purifier, the first air purifier of the brand with an honest price, is now making its debut. The specifications is obviously allowing switch-on mode, automatic mode, sleep mode and other adjustment features such as smart propagation or setting the timer for 2, 4 or 8 hours. The Realme TechLife Air Purifier therefore arrives on the market at an exchangeable price of around 3,999 Thai baht, that is around 105 euros. The next Nokia flagship phone is confirmed by November 11. Nokia Mobile Product Manager in China has confirmed the same on Weibo. Details regarding the Nokia flagship phone are not revealed yet. A smartphone from Oppo has been spotted on the certification platform. It seems to have a design like that of gaming-oriented smartphone such as Asus ROG Phone 5. Oppo gaming smartphone renders have been revealed in these certifications. Nothing Year One price has been officially confirmed by the company. The earbuds will cost us around £99, that is exactly right ₹10,200 at launch, and it also features an active noise cancellation. Nothing Year One price in India could be a bit lower. Redmi K40 Ultra specifications have surfaced online. It is expected to feature a 120Hz AMOLED screen, MediaTek Dimensity 1200 chipset, 67W fast charging and a 64MP quad rear camera. Redmi K40 Ultra appears to be a rebadged version of Redmi K40 Gaming Edition launched earlier this year. In late 2019, Xiaomi unveiled the Mi Mix Alpha with a curious design that had a single screen wrap around the front, side and back of the device. Then earlier this year, it was launched its first foldable smartphone, which is called as Mi Mix Fold. What if there was a phone that combined both these designs? Xiaomi has already considered such a possibility and filed a patent on the design last year, though the documents were only made publicly available today. The device really does look like a mix between the Alpha and the Fold. It is essentially an inverted folder, except that the secondary screen on the outside is not a separate panel, but instead a portion of the main panel that wraps around the inside of one of the foldable halves. Xiaomi is gearing up for the launch of new Redmi smartphone in India. The company recently unveiled the Mi 11 Lite as its mid-range smartphone in the country. Earlier this year, Xiaomi launched its most expensive smartphone in India, the Mi 11 Ultra. The device is going on sale for the first time on July 7th. As it gear up for the sale, Xiaomi, citing a Counterpoint research report, has also announced some details around its performance in the premium smartphone segment. The company claims that it has managed to achieve a 14% market share in the sub ₹20,000 to ₹40,000 category. Mi 12 may launch before the end of this year. According to a new leak, Qualcomm is working on its next generation flagship processors, rumored to be called as a Snapdragon 895 processor, and this is expected to unveil in early December. Qualcomm is said to be half a month ahead of schedule, and this could result in the chipset launching earlier than expected. OEMs will also likely launch phones ahead of plans, and given that Xiaomi and Qualcomm have partnered many times in the past. Itel Smart TV 4K lineup launch date for the Indian market have been leaked. The upcoming TVs from the brand are said to be a premium offering. The key specifications include a 55-inch and a 43-inch panel with 4K resolution, and it comes with a 24-watt speakers. It runs on Android TVOS and a MediaTek processors. Nintendo today announced a new version of the Switch console. The new variant, simply called as Nintendo Switch, features an updated display, increased storage, improved speakers, and a better design. The new feature here is a 7-inch OLED display. There is a bump up from the 6.2-inch IPS LCD on the standard model, although both feature the same 1280x720 resolution. Apple is expected to launch the new 2021 iPhone models in September. According to the leaked information, the tentative date for the next iPhone launch is set for September 14. Apple is expected to launch four new models, two of which will have a Pro features. One such feature coming to the high-end iPhones is the inclusion of ProMotion display, which is an Apple moniker for the 120Hz refresh rate screen. According to the new report, the 2022 iPhones will have a 120Hz refresh rate display as standard. Today, the Chinese smartphone giant has unveiled the Huawei Nova 8i smartphone in the country with specifications like 66-watt fast charging, 64-megapixel quad camera, and an edgeless display. The smartphone is priced at $312 for the sole 8GB RAM and 128GB storage variant. It comes in interstellar blue, moonlight silver, and starry black color variants. The phone will go on pre-order starting from today till July 21st. Those who will pre-book the phone will get the benefits worth $63. Huami Technology announced that it will be holding its next BEAT conference in China later this month. The conference will have the company showcase the future of health on 13 July 2021. Notably, the Department of Cardiovascular Internal Medicine of Peking University Hospital worked with the company to carry out clinical research to detect atrial fibrillations in smart bands back in 2019. Thanks for watching this video. Please kindly support my channel by giving a like, share, and subscribe. And follow Digi Integrity on Twitter, Instagram, and Facebook.